right, so what I have here is I have a file I got in from a customer. I have to determine which version of InDesign that file is, and is the file integrity good, because it could be a bad file. So here, I'm just going to show you how I'm getting it from the same USB drive. I'm going to get this file here, modified 1114, size 19.3 megabytes, same file. I'm going to first put it here on this MacBook Pro, a more modern machine I use with the more modern applications for desktop publishing. InDesign CC, InDesign CS6, Quark 9, Quark 10, all that kind of stuff. All right, so now I've had the file here. Now what I'm going to do, we see the file here. What you can do on a Macintosh is very simply, you click once on the file and you do a command I from Isaac. And what you get is this, very handy for all intents and purposes, accurate way to see information about this file. Now we see it was created 1114 like we just saw. We see the size and we see the kind, an InDesign CC document. So that's rather interesting, because what you're going to see in a moment, if I take the same exact file on another machine, it's going to tell me the kind is an InDesign something else version file. And there's a reason for that, but it's one of the things that confuses many people out in the market is, what version InDesign file do I have here? Can I open it? Can I use it? And Markzware is working on these problems for you. So anyway, we see on this machine, it's an InDesign CC file, and that's that. Now what I'm going to do now is for the customer, and I'm going to do that with FlightCheck by dragging and dropping the file on FlightCheck down here in my dock. FlightCheck will start up, and FlightCheck will tell me which version of the file this really is. Now you see I have InDesign, you see FlightCheck says it's done with preflighting and checking the file for inventory, also very important. Doesn't necessarily have to be a problem, just tell us what's in the file. On this machine I have CC and CS6, and that's why when you do a command I, you get that InDesign CC. Now, besides all the results here, which any preflighter would love to use, we're going to skip right on over to the main window. And in particular, this file info. And what we'll see right away is that it's a version 8 file of InDesign, meaning, as actually the customer's file name implies, it is a CS6 file. And it's a little bit confusing for some folks, because there's CS6, but it's version 8. Why isn't CS6 version 6 dot something? But you can just do a quick Google search and you'll see that version 8.x.x is a CS6 type of file. Okay? CS9 would be CC. InDesign versioning chart should show up, right here from Markzware. Downsave InDesign file, how to open CS6 file and CS3. And this can apply also to CC and all the other versions as well. And what you see there is you get a very handy chart how to downsave InDesign file. But what's important for this chart, you can very quickly see that version 8 of InDesign is a CS6 and version 7.5. is version CS5.5, and version 7 is CS5, and version 6 is CS4, and version 5 is CS3, version 4 is CS. Kind of confusing. So this kind of chart can help you, and we should update this to include CC. The main thing I wanted to highlight here is how this file on this modern machine shows up as CC, even though it's actually a CS6, as we just saw on FlightCheck. Now let's go over to my other machine, my older machine, my workhorse as I call it, and see what that Mac tells us. All right, so now I'm down here on my older MacBook Pro. Now, what I'm going to do is take that same exact file, which is here, and I'm going to put it in my hard drive. It had it there, but we'll just replace the file, along with a lot of other test files. If I do a command I, well, look at that. It says it's an InDesign CS5 document. Now it is 11:14 a.m. same and the same size, but because on this machine CS5 is my main InDesign application for converting files for customers and fixing bad InDesign files, yeah, that's what you get. So it's very confusing. it's actually a CS6 file. On the other machine, it says it's CC. And on this machine, it says it's CS5. That's why I need Markzware's FlightCheck, another Markzware technology that will be forthcoming to help you convert these files, to help you understand what files you're dealing with. So just to highlight exactly what I mean, here in CS5, and when I try to open up that file, we just double-click it, and InDesign will come back, and unfortunately, like many of you know, will tell us this. Well, it's not really a missing plugin. Well, yes, technically it is, but you know, designers are now freaking out, publishers, printers freak out, and they contact Markzware if they find us, and we can help them. So that's no problem. We can downsave the files for you. We have a conversion service link below, which we can do this for you. But in any event, in the meantime, you're freaking out, and you get all these different error messages that just keep coming across, and the file just will not open. Now, what is rather funky, you can take that same file, open it in CS6 or CC, export as .idml, and it will open in CS5, and more or less be perfectly okay. You can get some things which will disappear or shift that you have to be careful with, but that exporting to IDML is necessary, and otherwise you get this. You just cannot open file. That's the problem. Markzware also has a file conversion service, which I'll give you more information on, where we can downsave InDesign files for you. Markzware offers many plugins and extensions to help you convert files from Quark to InDesign, from InDesign to Quark, from PDF to InDesign, pretty much you name it. Check out Markzware.com today, and we hope this tip has helped you. Thank you, David Dilling from Markzware, wishing you a fantastic day.